Greetings, this is Emily, and I'd like to welcome you to this unit edit video. I've been rejected by one journal. Should I resubmit to the same journal or try another? Some, especially less experienced authors, believe that if their paper is not accepted for publication on their first submission, then there is no chance of publication in that journal. This reaction is understandable, but not realistic. Successful publication on first submission is very rare. Authors need to learn how to comprehend the journal response letter and what actions on the paper or research are required before resubmitting the same paper. However, sometimes a paper is rejected from a journal with no chance of publication in that journal. The author should learn how to identify this situation too and look for a new target journal. Typical journal responses to a paper submission. Review decisions on papers come in five forms: accept, accept with minor revisions, accept with major revisions, revise and resubmit, or reject. Let's review the definition for each decision on paper. If a journal says they accept, this means the journal publishes your paper in its current state. If the journal says accept with minor revisions, the journal is willing to publish your paper given you or the co-authors make minor corrections as suggested by the reviewers or handling editor. If the journal says accept with major revisions, the journal is willing to publish your paper given you or the co-authors make major corrections as suggested by the reviewers and/or the handling editor. If the decision on the paper is to revise and resubmit, this means that the journal rejects your paper in its current state, but is willing to consider publishing it following major revisions and a new peer review cycle. If the decision on the paper is reject, the journal will not publish your paper in its current state or any alternative or modified states. One of these decisions on your paper determines its fate for that journal and whether or not you can resubmit to the same journal. Receiving an outright rejection decision on your paper from a journal is usually the final decision at the handling editor's or editor-in-chief's discretion. Therefore, if rejected, your only option is to submit to another journal. Can a reject decision be changed? Only in extenuating circumstances can authors contest a paper rejection. Two types of issues, editorial and technical. Let's look at the different kinds of issues that you might see in a journal response letter. Each kind of issue requires a different action by the author. Some issues don't prevent you resubmitting to the same journal. Other issues do mean that you need to find a new target journal. Lack of adherence to journal formatting requirements. To fix, this issue can be fixed by language editors and the paper can be resubmitted to the same journal. If the editorial issue is a lack of clarity, quality, or detail in language and data presentation, the issue can be fixed by language editors. If the issue is insufficient up-to-date references, the issue can be fixed by the authors by adding and updating the references and the paper can be resubmitted to the same journal. If the editorial issue is insufficient impact or value for the journal, this journal does not feel this paper is a good fit, you should consider submitting to another journal. If the issue is that it is out of scope for the journal, the paper could be submitted to another journal as it could be within the scope of another journal. If the technical issue is that it is weak, unclear, or scientifically invalid, research objectives or hypotheses, a possible action would be that it could be fixed by the authors by strengthening and revising the objectives or hypotheses. Editors can clarify the language, and the paper can be resubmitted to the same journal depending on the review decision. If the issue is with data, for example, the sample size is too small, the controls are missing or are poor, the data does not answer the questions posed or support the assumptions or conclusions drawn, this issue can be fixed by the authors by addressing the limitations of the sample size and controls and reanalyzing, rephrasing how the data supports or rejects the assumptions or questions posed. Editors can clarify the language and the paper can be resubmitted to the same journal depending upon the review decision. If the problem is inappropriate or outdated methodology or poor analysis, such as inappropriate statistical tests, this issue can be fixed by the authors by modifying and updating the methodology and strengthening the analysis using the appropriate tests. Editors can clarify the language and the paper can be resubmitted to the same journal depending on the review decision. Practical example for life sciences. Most journals within the life sciences employ the same paper accepted criteria previously discussed in this video. In the notes of the video will be a useful link to a SlideShare presentation on how to write a scientific paper and get it published. Practical example for social sciences. Journals within the social sciences rely on the general criteria outlined previously in the video, with the exception of cases whereby you can demonstrate that the reviewers are subject to unfair bias or have misunderstood the research. Generally, however, it is ideal to pursue a new journal following rejection by submitting the next highest impact journal on your list of preferred publications for the research. Determine a new target journal. If the reason for rejection is based on the unsuitability of your research or results for the journal, determining the right journal to submit to is your priority. Reading past issues of one journal to acquire a sense of the aims, scope, level, length, and readership of the journal could help you determine if the journal is right for your research and thus enhance the probability of your research being accepted. Once again, this is Emily from UniEdit. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day.